Hey gang, Scott Davenport here. This is the first video in what will grow to become a series on printing, printing your photos, printing your work. I've been doing more printing in the last several months. I've been getting a lot of questions about, you know, what am I doing with color management or the setup in Lightroom? What type of paper am I using? All that kind of stuff. You know, what kind of printer do you have? And so I thought I'd put together a series of videos on printing. And I wanted to start with basically the fundamental question, why print your work? That was something I would ask myself when I first started photography. It's digital photography. We're all using screens. That's how we're sharing. You know, most of my work is consumed through some type of electronic device. Why print? Well, I'm going to give you five reasons in this video of why I print. So let's get going. Right, first reason, and the most important one to me, is printing makes me a better photographer. When I print out a photo and I look at it and hold it in my hands, a piece of paper, It appears different, and I am learning more about composition. I'll notice things on the printed page that I don't notice on the screen. I'll notice more flaws in my processing when I've printed that I might not notice on the screen, whether it's a dust spot or, you know, I don't know, just an edge that doesn't look right, whatever it may be. And that becomes a nice feedback loop. And so I see those things, I print things out, I recognize that as a problem, and I iterate on that. I become a better photographer. I really think the big one there is compositionally. You know, I've got a couple here that are the same print. And this one is, I had to crop for an 8x10. It's helping me improve my cropping skills. You know, what really is the most important parts of this scene to get this on the paper in this size so it has the most impact? So reason number one, you're gonna improve as a photographer. Reason number two is greeting cards. That one kind of sounds a little bit odd. I don't buy cards anymore. I print my own. You know, greeting cards, at least nice ones, have gotten expensive over the years. But more so, I like to express my own artwork and share it with people. So I'll get, you know, 7x10 cardstock. It makes a nice 5x7 card. You print your artwork on it. You can leave the inside open, write your own messages. You can print on whatever you want. And I can have an unlimited supply of greeting cards, you know, virtually unlimited supply for a very economical cost. I'll do that for holiday cards, birthday cards, thank you cards, all sorts of stuff. And I think that a printed card, you know, one that you have created and given someone, that's kind of a novel thing in the digital world, right? We have e-cards and all that kind of stuff, but to get not only a card from someone in the mail, but one that they have created with their own photography, that's kind of a neat thing. So I really like making cards with my photos, and it's a great way to make use of your printer. Reason number three, it's fun and it's something new to learn. Learning is something I really, really enjoy. And one of the things that drew me to photography, in addition to going out and being in nature, all the landscape stuff I love doing, it's a never-ending source of learning. There's always something new to learn in photography. And printing is a whole nother realm of learning things. If you've got your asset management down, you got your post-processing skills all sharpened, take a look at printing. It's an entirely new area to open up and understand. And it feeds back to the first reason, is making you a better photographer. You'll learn more about color and about composition, and all those things will feed back and make you better behind the camera as well. Just in the handful of months that I've really seriously gotten into the printing things, you know, I've learned more about color, color theory, color management, and just how I think the picture I have on screen will translate to a print. And it's a ton of fun. So, you know, don't discount the fun part of printing. Reason number four is changing the mood of your photo with the medium that you print it on. I've got this photo of a sunset happening over Sunset Cliffs in San Diego. I've printed it on two different mediums. This first one is a Red River Polar Metallic paper, and so the photo's got a little more bite to it. The details, as I look at this on the hills, they're just a little bit crisper. And the photo, you know, those land masses, they jump out a little bit more, and it's got a little more punch to it. I printed the same photo on an acrylic. Now on the acrylic, it's very similar, but the land tones are a little more muted. Those extra edges and grit and detail in the hillsides, it's a little bit different just because of the print medium. And as I look at this one, this is a little more pastoral. You know, it feels a little more peaceful. Both photos are still very pleasing and I like them both, but the medium choice changes the mood of the photo. Now, and this is just two examples. You get into something where you've got a matte finish or a satin finish, maybe fine art paper that's actually feels really, really, really good in the hands. I did a video on this paper bake-off that I did, and there was one paper stock. I wasn't too keen on the color tone it was giving my photos, but the feel of it was incredible. And so, you know, mental note about that paper style, that might be something else I want to use for a different project. So having different choices in the medium and how that's going to affect the mood of your photo, it's another, hidden wonder and new realm to explore in printing. The fifth reason is the level of control that you can have over the entire process. And this is really for printing at home. You can choose the type of paper. You can color calibrate your devices so you can have an end-to-end color management experience from screen all the way to the printed page. You can choose not to do some of those things. You have the level of control or the first right of refusal if those things don't interest you. I've got a bit of a nerd streak in me, and I enjoyed getting into the color management and how to calibrate devices. And I've done some videos on those pieces already and will be incorporated throughout this this series on printing. But the level of control that you have and what it leads to, it feeds back into that learning reason for me. Another area to explore, learn, and ultimately feed back into becoming a better photographer overall. So those are a few of the reasons that motivate me to print my work. I'm sure you could rattle off a bunch more if you're into printing already as well. It really does come down to becoming a better photographer and just growing your knowledge of photography. I'm really enjoying it. I'm having a lot of fun. And I hope this sets some good context for the set of videos that will follow this one. I'm going to talk about a bunch of different things, choosing a printer to ICC color profiles, calibrating devices, and some basics about setting up the print jobs within Lightroom. And maybe we'll do some stuff with how to print cards as well, if that's something of interest to you. If there's a particular topic about printing you'd like to hear more about, leave some notes in the comments below. If you want to keep it private, shoot me a message through my website. Love to hear from you. And stay tuned for some more printing videos. My name is Scott Davenport. Happy shooting.